Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. In this one I'll ramble a bit about some things I think you might do and hinder your progress, or just, I don't know, regret it later as a new player or even an intermediate player. I'll start with an easy to fix mistakes and we end up with the worst ones I could think of. So let's begin.
Hook-tua.
You ride the bike over a train rail expecting it to go over the tracks like a normal bike would do. Well, no, that's not the case. Yeah, I know, this is not important and people would learn it on their own with no consequence, but it was shocking for me to see. It still is, and my god, it's annoying. Once human developers don't believe in ramps, you know, the real number one now. Don't miss out on loot when you're in a mission phased out. If you find, for example, a weapon crate in there, odds are you will find it if you go back after it's done. It works on resources, nodes and plants. You follow the path that the game's bad GPS plots you when you click some point of interest on the map. Don't do that. Especially if you go downhill. I usually go straight to my destination if I can. Over long periods of time, I think this thing alone saves you a lot of time. You watched a tier list or something that was telling you not to take the backpack expansion memetic specialization. Well, if you play solo like I am and don't really try to engage with others too much and you get presented with a backpack expansion memetic specialization, just take it. I enjoy the extra backpack size a lot. Some say it's crap and you don't need it, but it depends on what you have in that batch presented to you. Most of the time this specialization would come on top, for me at least. But yeah, you can buy this from other people, that's why I said if you are a lone wolf, you should take it. On my main character I don't have it and I constantly get out of space while exploring. You pass out on very important memetic specialization because you didn't realize how valuable some options are. If you get Sulfur Chemist as one of the options, don't pass it. Take it and start doing acid when you can. I mean, you can get some pretty fast, especially with the food that buffs the drop rates, but having it passively must be great. I wouldn't know though. So yeah, I was unlucky so far with two characters. I have three more draws with this alt I've made and one or two respects with her, so yeah, wish me luck. You craft a lot of lures as you can't stop fishing in this game for some reason. If you're into fishing, get Frog the Leaper early. The mistake you can make and cost you a ton of materials early is to craft lures needed for fishing. I got this guy early in the first zone while doing a puzzle. I forgot the place, I'm sorry. There are specific spots you can look for him and you can change the servers and go back to check if he's there until you find him. He gives you a lot of lures. At the moment I got like hundreds and I fish quite a bit. You don't pay attention to the house icons on your map. As you progress through it, completing the rift anchors and stuff, take a look at the outside source for what's nearby the places you visit. I'll put the link in the description of this video. A lot of times you'll make sure you don't miss out on stuff like Morphe crates, and those are in my opinion at least very hard to spot if you're not looking specifically at the blinking light on your character's back. Or some puzzle locations that grant you some early attachments for your weapons. Explore most house icons as they have cool stuff around them. Some have all of the above nearby, plus some gear and weapon crates. You see this icon on your building menus but not on your actual facility? Rebuild that one facility ASAP. If you get a memetic specialization at some point that boosts one of your workbenches in a way, you need to rebuild that. So just demolish the old one and build a new one. If you assume the buffs apply automatically, you missed out, as they don't. And now a special mention at number 6.
You haven't watched my review of the game yet, I'm sure. This is cardinal sin.
And you should be in jail.
In all seriousness, now go watch it if you have some time, you might find it useful. Also, you can subscribe to the channel to be the first to find out about the new videos I will release weekly. I play once human at the moment, but looking at my channel you realize I mix things up quite a bit. If you fancy that kind of thing, go for it, press the button. With that out of the way, let's continue. So you have some deviants and you pass like the 10th extra dimensional cat for the day without bothering to get it. Well, stop doing that and get every single Deviant you see, because they are a great Eternal Land income. You can sell all the extra Deviants you don't need in there for the currency that allows you to build in that place. They sell for 500 a pop. So yeah, take each one you see. At some point you forgot what parts of the map you explored. The way I found it alleviates that to some extent is to put markers on it, especially for puzzles and memetic rates. Just pick a symbol out of the 5 for a category of items and stick with it. This one, for example, I use for crates in the places I like to farm high-end mods and gear. You could have one, for example, with places you know are likely to have divines spawned or specific resources like moral seeds and so on. You are new to the game or you just don't know any better, and keep the default camera settings. Camera autofollow is the worst thing in this game. Get rid of it as it will hinder you. When I drive around, I like to sweep the horizon side to side in search for a divine plant or rare ores, I don't know. You can do that with the camera autofollow on, and you have more spatial awareness if you don't fight the damn camera all the time. For the love of what's holy, at least try it out, you might like it. And to devs, you should really change it so the default is off. I didn't find a way to disable it when you climb ladders, for example, and that is equally annoying, but luckily you don't climb stairs that often. Just give us control, guys. It's not good as it is. You spend all that star chrome as you get it, with no real purpose, or you just, I don't know, like... Don't waste it. Try to find out what build you want and like early. Usually that's dictated by the weapon and mods you have. So early into the game you'll get this shrapnel SMG that's pretty good, and a great power surge assault rifle, or the Black Panther sniper rifle, or the bounce or frost vortex light machine guns. TLDR of this, I'm pretty sure you can try out any build you'd like early for cheap to figure out what you want at the end game. You don't need to have a complementary armor set to boost your desired stats and damage just yet. I could finish what the game had to offer solo on my main with a mishmash of pieces, unupgraded and unoptimized mods. Now, after this long parallel, let's go back to StarChrome and why you should not waste it early. Unless you know exactly what you want, like I did with the second character. I knew I want to go shrapnel something, and I tried my luck with the last valor blueprint of the wish machine. I managed to get it and even upgrade it once, so I sit at a 2-star legendary weapon at level 30. For a bit, I don't know, 4000 StarChrome or something. But I'll stop doing that for the time being and just hoard it. This resource will carry to the next season anyway, so it's not like I'm going to lose it or anything. You've fused all your blueprints as you got them, and now you have a lot of them, but all are 1-star. I must place this on pretty much on top of the list, because this thing stopped my progression in its tracks. On my main, I fused all my blueprints as they came, all of them. Then I couldn't upgrade any of my desired blueprints at the endgame. On that character I don't have many enhanced items. But on my alt, I already have my beret at 4 stars, because I know what I want and I don't know, I don't fuse anything until I know I need it. I still use scrap tier 2 gear that doesn't help me at all on my build, but I don't care about it as I don't need more, I don't know, power. When I need it, I'll figure out something out. As long as I can kill stuff at a decent speed and mobs don't kill me, I don't need an upgrade necessarily. With subpar gear you might get one shot by a boss or something, but whatever, it's still perfectly doable. This ties nicely with the previous point. You can still progress through the rift tankers with the tier 2 or 3 gear set, but you can do the tier 4 and you decide to go for it. I'd wait for a few levels and go straight for the tier 5, you know. You could do the main weapon, sure, so upgrade your weapon to tier 4. So you have extra power, but do not upgrade the entire gear set, it's not worth it. You are dead set to create a beautiful house, like I am, but the game doesn't let you. Or you don't know how to do it and waste hours of your time in the process. Well, go for it if you really enjoy it, but be warned, you will not find reliable ways to do certain things you might want to do with your build. This being due to the lack of modules or just a bad snapping, I suggest you stop wasting time, as this is not a properly polished game system in my opinion. For example, I have a very big issue with the roof. I just can't complete it. I can't place the last pieces for the life of me. Perhaps if I would try to widen the entire wall by one module, making it 5 tiles wide, I could, I don't know, complete it somehow, but I'm not willing to try it. Well, I hope this made sense and will help you waste as little time and resources as possible in the future, and if you found any value in this, tell me in the comments. You could also share if you are experienced at the game, what are your top mistakes you wish you didn't do when you started playing Once Human. I learned a few things myself from you guys in the comments of this video, so yeah, you might want to check out my silo or boss guides, as I think I have one for each one by this point. I only like the first boss from the list because he's really easy. Thank you for watching, and until next time, take care and see ya.